NATO member Romania reported a possible violation of its airspace during an overnight Russian attack in neighboring Ukraine, saying it had not found debris on Romanian territory but would continue the search on Saturday. After Russia exited the deal, which allowed safe grain shipments through the Black Sea, the strikes on Ukraine's southern Mykolaiv and Odessa regions have been ramped up by Russia. The regions are home to vital grain exporting infrastructure. The Romanian army's radar system detected a possible unauthorized breach of the country's airspace after registering groups of drones heading towards Ukrainian territory near the border as Russia conducted a new series of attacks on some targets in Ukraine, the Romanian Defense Ministry said. Fragments of possible Russian drones were found in Romanian territory three separate times this month, underlying the security risks for NATO, whose members have a mutual defense commitment. Around midnight, residents of Galati and Talsia, which face the port of Reni in southern Ukraine across the Danube, received alerts warning them to take shelter. The alert measures were lifted around 2 hours later. Earlier this month, Romanian soldiers built air raid shelters to protect the residents in the eastern Romanian village of Plauru after drone fragments were found in the area. Since Russia's invasion of Ukraine in February last year, NATO has been concerned to prevent the war from spilling over onto its territory. The Air Force of Ukraine claims to have shot down 30 out of 40 Iranian-made Shahed drones, which were launched by Russia in an overnight attack, said regional and military officials on Saturday. The South Military Command claimed that they shot down 20 drones in the central Vinnytsia region and 10 others over the Odessa and Mykolaiv regions in the south. Spokesperson for the Southern Command said that Russia continued attacking port infrastructure, which included those near the Danube River, and was also trying to strike critical infrastructure facilities in other regions of Ukraine to impact the economy. Meanwhile, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky opened the first International Defense Industries Forum of Kyiv so as to attract more manufacturers who will build arms in Ukraine. The officials from more than 30 countries and 250 defense firms have gathered for the forum, which is being organized as Zelensky lobbies the West, seeking more arms to wage a counter-offensive against Russia. Ukraine started its pushback to regain occupied territory in June, but has accepted that its troops are slowly progressing as they encounter lines of heavily fortified Russian defenses.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.